Get ready to match the stars. Larry Hovis, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Patty Doyle, Richard Dawson, and Madeline Rue as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
I shouldn't do that because these microphones are very expensive, and if I dropped it, it would bust.
Can't tell
break.
Doing
I'm sorry,
May
you can't
West
say bust on television. What's that? We missed a golden.
No, I just said I couldn't tell if you were doing a Mae West or a Julius Monk impression.
I have a secret about what is, Charles what is Nelson Reilly.
What's that?
Oh. He's not wearing any socks again.
And they'll never know.
No, you'll never know because he's not going to show. Are you ready?
Ready.
All right.
Ready.
You're ready to play?
Ready.
Are you ready to play? Okay. Now, let me just explain briefly. The last time out, when we ran out of time, we were right in the middle of round two. Candy Carter here is our current champ. She's won $5,700, which is pretty good. Two games, right?
Right.
And she's being challenged by Arlene Bissot. Why can't I pronounce your name? Arlene Bissot. It's an easy name. What kind of name is that, Arlene?
French-Canadian.
French-Canadian. Okay, there's a bus leaving in 5 minutes. No. Arlene is ahead 4-0, and you've got one shot at it here. And we'll see what happens right after we see these messages. Okay, here we go. I'll push the button and reveal one question for Candy Carter. You must match four celebrities to stay in the game. Five, however, Candy, will win the game. All right, here we go. Everybody plays. How to make a good first impression on a girl. 1, bring her flowers. 2, tell her she's beautiful. 3, show her your blank.
Jack did the last one. Tell her your flowers, show her.
Bring her flowers, tell her she's beautiful. Show her your blank. Show her your blank, yeah.
Show her your blank.
Would I lie to you, Charles? Charles knows me too well. All right, Patty is now finished, so that means we can press on here. Go to Candy Carter. How to make a good first impression on a girl, bring her flowers, tell her she's beautiful, show her your...
Money.
Money. Money is her answer. Larry?
Uh-huh. Oh.
It's show and tell time.
Yeah, well, that's kind of flashing through my mind.
Yeah.
I said bankroll.
Bankroll. Is that much money? It does indeed. There's one for you, Candy. 4-tie, 5-win. Brett?
I told you my life hasn't been easy. Jack Klugman never brought me flowers, never told me I was pretty. But he did show me his personality.
Show her. Indeed he did. Okay.
Well, just forget it. If you kids don't understand... I'm sorry.
Charles, go ahead. Charles, you're on.
Bank book.
Bank book. Is that money? That's money. Okay. Here we go to Patty Deutsch.
Wallet.
Wallet and money is another match.
Oh, boy. I'm out.
One more to tie, Candy. And you've got two people to go. Here's person number one. You're number one, you know.
Bachelor number one. I live at home in Malibu with my mother. And I'm sick about it. I tell you, I always give them flowers.
Yep.
Candy.
Tell them they're beautiful.
And then show them my technique.
Okay. Okay.
Well, thank you.
No match there. And we'll move over to Madeline Rue. You must match Madeline to stay in the game. If you don't match her... Why, we've got a new champion. Go.
Well, I thought money was a little too crass. If he was more subtle, he could show you his house.
Show the house! So, Arlene is the winner. Congratulations. Come on down.
$100 for you. Best wishes.
Tandy's got to leave us now, but she's very happy, I guess, to leave and start spending her money. It's $5,700. Thank you and congratulations,
you.
Tandy Carter.
Thank you very much.
Goodbye, Tandy. Bye. How do you feel?
Pretty good.
Pretty good? All right, you can win over $5,000 here now in the super match coming up here. How do you think that make you feel if you win?
Terrific.
Okay, it's pretty good versus terrific. Let's begin. We polled a recent studio audience, Arlene, and we got their best response to this. Silent blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100. Now, you may allow allowed to get a little help. Anybody know when this audience was polled, Ira? Would it be informative or interesting to say both to Arlene and to the celebrities when this audience was polled?
Several weeks ago.
Okay. Which ones would you like to get some help from?
Larry,
what do you say?
Butler.
Silent Butler. Okay, there's one.
Charles.
Well, it's, you know, Silent Night.
Silent Night. Okay.
Richie.
What'd you say, Richard?
There's something you were in, the silent movies, Gene.
Yes, right. Yeah, of course.
Great. That's wonderful. Beautiful job.
Gotcha again. Okay, so you've got Silent Butler, Silent Night, and Silent Movies. You may choose one of those, Arlene, or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Silent Night.
Silent Night is the answer she wants? Okay. I hope it's not too seasonal. That's why I asked Ira about, you know, when this audience was polled. He said it was several weeks ago. It may or may not work. We'll find out right now. She's looking for Silent Night. May we see the $100 response? Silent Partner is a very good answer, and none of the dummies over there thought of it. All right, you're still looking for Silent Night. Here's the $250 response. Silent Alarm is a rotten answer. All right, third and last chance, Arlene, to get Silent Night. Let's find out if it's under the $500 response. Silent Night it is! Attaboy, Charles! Okay. Now, Arlene, you've won the $500. And that means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect, you got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Which one will it be?
Charles.
Yeah.
All right, hello. Charles, you get ready, right, and you will face me, Arlene, and I'll get the $5,000.
Good luck, Arlene.
Thank you.
Here it is. Double blank. Double blank.
May it be more than one word?
Whatever you think will match Arlene. If it's more than one word in your judgment that will match her, that's what you'll write. But don't give her any broad clues like that, Charles. No, it's hard to tell what he's doing. He's thinking. They're both thinking.
Well, no, it's
hard.
Wonderful.
Double blank.
They're both.
All right. Charles has so many good answers, he couldn't think of one. He finally did think of one. He wrote it, and it's in the slot. And now, Arlene, how do you fill in that blank? Double?
Trouble.
Double trouble. All right, Charles, for $5,000, may we see a response?
I said double or nothing.
Double or nothing. Double or nothing.
And I won't tell her what I wrote on the other card.
Yeah, well, they're both good answers, double or nothing or in double trouble. All right, now, Arlene, you're up to $600. You're going to meet another player, but first we've got to pass along this message to you. Now we're ready to start another game, and to do that, we've got to introduce a new player. So let's welcome Mr. Tom McClay. Hi, Tom. Tom's a snappy dresser, isn't he? You're a neat dresser, Tom. What else can you tell us about yourself?
Originally from the Bronx and came out to Los Angeles. There you go.
Hello, Bronx.
Came out to Los Angeles in the service, and now I'm a real estate salesman in Hollywood.
Okay, welcome.
Thank you.
Good luck to you. Good luck to you. You've had it already, but good luck anyway. I'll push a button and reveal two questions. Ask you, Tom, to make a selection. We do that because some contestants find some questions harder than others.
I think I'll have A.
You'll have A? All right, Tom wants A. This is it.
Give it to him.
Homer said, Uh-huh. Homer said I was nearly inducted into the Army until I showed up at the draft board with a blank. Homer said I was nearly inducted into the Army until I showed up at the draft board with a blank. Think about that for a second, Tom. Were you in the Army?
I was in the Air Force.
In the Air Force.
Right.
All right, the lower tier is ready.
We're the best.
Yeah, you are the best. The atmosphere is rare up there.
We're the fastest. Find it.
You what?
The fastest.
The fastest.
Not necessarily the best, but the fastest.
You know, Charles is slower than I am, and he still isn't wearing any socks.
Done? Okay. Now he's ready. Tom McClay. Homer said I was nearly inducted into the Army until I showed up at the draft board with a...
boyfriend.
He said boyfriend, folks.
I heard him.
You said, oh, you did hear him.
Yeah.
What did you say, Larry?
Pardon me? well, I think that's disgusting. I said husband.
I see. That's a little different from boyfriend, isn't it? All right, Brett.
Why are you even going together?
Yes, yes. No, that you can't match that. Boyfriend and husband do not match.
Since when?
What do you say?
I say I came here to be refreshed, not insulted by that man's filthy remarks. Boyfriend.
Boyfriend is our answer. There's one for you, Tom. Charles?
Well, where they had the examinations with the courthouse steps. And he couldn't get up the courthouse steps because he came and, excuse me for this answer, because I love the work of Morristown, New York, where they trained the seeing eye dogs.
Okay.
He had a seeing eye dog.
All right.
And we'll move right on.
Certainly threw
right.
Paul over this party.
Patty, what did you say to this?
I said he showed up at the induction center with a dress on.
With a dress on. That's your answer, right, audience? You're that kind of a bunch. Okay.
And a smart feather fan.
Right. And Richard Dawson.
I never thought of that. I wore a miniskirt, but I meant it just never occurred to me. I brought a purse.
A purse.
Yeah. Got me into the wax, by the way.
Madeline?
Time
dress on.
A dress on. All right, so boyfriend got you one match there, and now we'll move to Arlene's question, which is as follows. Stop that.
Oh, sorry.
Whatever you're doing, stop.
Pay attention. I know.
I had a secret.
The bellhop got even with Robert for not tipping. He put blank in his bed. The bellhop got even with Robert for not tipping. He put blank in his bed. Do you have a sequin there?
I took it off.
No, there's no sequins on your cheek.
Would you like to put some?
Keep me out of the army.
I don't know. What do I know?
That's right, you don't know. All right, we're all set. So, Arlene, we call on you. Wait a minute, I'm all tangled. Here we go. The bellhop got even with Robert for not tipping. He put blank in his bed.
Ice.
Ice in his bed. Okay, Larry. Ice.
Ice, see? I said crumbs.
Crumbs is another good answer. Yeah. Very good answer. Brett?
Well...
She
didn't even show yet, and you're buzzing already. At least be decent enough to wait until she gives her rotten answer.
I would think so. Now you're asking for trouble, and you're going to be in terrible trouble when I get at you. Please.
Please, it has been. Charles?
And if they don't have wings, they're bugs.
Bugs, okay. No, ice is the answer. What did you say?
I said he put the bell captain in his bed.
The bell captain in his bed, yeah. Oh, it was thrilling.
That doesn't necessarily have to be bad, honey.
All right. Richard?
Hi, dear.
How are you? We've got our own Lillian Ross up there. Ice is the only answer.
Ice is the answer. 1-1 the score. Madeline?
Well, my ice melted.
Water. No, can't melt, can't match ice and water. So it's 1-1 at the end of round one. We'll come to round two right after we come to this message for you. 1-1 the score. I'll push a button, reveal two questions in our second and final round, ask our challenger, Tom, to make a selection.
B.
B, last time out you matched Brett, so Brett, you will not participate. Everyone else will.
Do you know what a rare thing it is for me to see Don't Write on my little thing
it
here?
It is rare, isn't it?
Yes.
Do you feel happy?
Well, good. I don't know. I feel left out.
How rare it is that she can read the words, so.
Don't encourage him. Here we go.
Okay, let's go.
Quiet. Peter said to Dumb Dora, "That's not the TV you're watching, it's the blank." Peter said to Dumb Dora, "That's not the TV you're watching, it's the blank."
I'm glad I don't have to write.
Yeah, that may be a hard
one. Confess.
Finished.
Am I making you nervous?
Larry, were you slow as a child also?
No.
Do you know, the first part of the week he was the neatest little printer, and now it's all gone down the drain.
All right, we're ready now. Tom. Peter said to Dumb Dora, "That's not the TV you're watching, it's the blank."
Boob tube.
Well,
that's the same thing.
That's his answer.
Proud Sterling Nutley.
Yeah. He said boob tube.
Okay.
And Larry, that's his answer. What's yours?
Oh, mine.
Yeah.
I almost said washing machine, but I said window.
Window, yeah. Washing machine is, I always said, with the kind, right. You know, the round, the front loaders,
I think
as they call
both
them.
Lousy answers.
Now, Charles, what did you say?
I said radio. Hello.
That's the radio. All right, boob tube is his answer. And Patty, yours is?
I said the washing machine.
Yes, that seems to be a good answer. And Richard?
Right, it's called the Lloyd Bridges Hour. Washing machine.
The washing machine. And Madeline.
I went from an old movie to the fish tank.
Fish tank is a good answer. Okay, Tom, you might have misunderstood that. So, but that was your answer, and we had to accept it. Arlene, this is for you. You need one match to win the game. Here we go. The Jolly Green Giant said...
Is he back again?
Yeah, who does not play this time? Richard does not play. Ho, ho, ho! He said, ho, ho, ho! Would I like to blank the Statue of Liberty? Ho, ho, ho! Would I like to blank the Statue of Liberty?
Sit down, you're drunk.
I like your jelly.
Bro, man.
Ho, ho, ho!
What you do today, Daddy? Ooh,
everybody's finished over there, Arlene. Give us a response now to this. Would I like to blank the Statue of Liberty?
Kiss.
Kiss. One kiss will win the game for this lady. One kiss. Larry?
Make love to.
Make love to is not kissing. Sorry about that. One kiss will still win the game. Brett?
Well, everybody knows that the Jolly Green Giant is very athletic. He wanted to jump on the Statue of Liberty.
I see. Okay. Moving along to Charles Nelson Reilly's answer.
I'm glad I wasn't there for that. But anyway, he's famous for one thing, but this is a very deep answer because she already is one. He would like to can her.
Okay, Charles. Too intellectual for me. I just can't keep up with it. Patty, what did you say? One kiss wins the game for this little lady.
Well, this is the kiss.
There's the kiss wins the game. Congratulations. Another kiss? Okay. You had another kiss there in reserve in case you needed it. Another $100 for you. Stand by for a moment while we say goodbye to Tom McClay. Thank you for joining us on Match Game 74.
Thank you.
From Tom McClay backstage. Goodbye, Tom. Okay. Now, you're up to $700. You're going to have another go at the Super Match here. You've been here before. You know how it goes, so let's get right to it. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Hang blank. Hang blank. So, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, $250, $100. You know that. Now, a little help from our celebrities here, one at a time.
Charles.
Hang.
Up.
Hang up, he says. Okay, there's one.
Madeline.
Hangman.
Hangman. Okay.
Richard.
Something that Gene had in the silent films, a hangnail.
Hangnail, right.
Yeah. He hates me to say this.
So you've got hang up, hangnail, and hangman. You may choose one of those or give us an answer of your own, but we need an answer now. What will it be?
Hangover.
Hangover.
He had that too.
He had that too, he says. Okay, Hangover is the answer you are looking for. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, the $100 response. Hangover is right up there, right up front. Oh, boy, look at that. Listen, what do you think is under the 250, audience? Hangnail. All right, let's see what's under the $250 answer there. Hang 10. Surfers say that all the time. The $500 response is? Hang up. That's the one that Charles gave. Okay, we'll come back to this lady and tell you what happens next right after this message. Well, our time has just about expired, but we look forward to seeing all of you next time, and we hope you'll be able to join us. And how about you? Will you join us next time?
Definitely.
Oh, thanks awfully.
I have no choice.
You have no choice.
I have no
You're under contract. Poor girl. Okay, Gene Rayburn here for Match Game 74. Join us next time. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are a Westcox direct reading digital dial light alarm clock, wood grain finish, lighted dial, backed by years of experience. Westcox, Italian Industries Company. And a supply of fantastic spray cleaner. Clean without bug or mess, just spray, wipe, and dirt's gone. Fantastic from Texas. And a supply of Swiss Miss Instant Cocoa Mix, made with real miniature marshmallows and good non-fat dry milk already in it. You just add water. This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Tottenham production. To match the stars from Charlie's Angels, David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rivers.
Thank you, Johnny O. Friends, thank you for joining us. I thank you for joining us. Have you got
it? Enough, Ira.
Have you been rehearsing it?
I get notes every day that I don't applaud for your entrance.
Yeah. Not only mine, but when we introduce celebrities, other celebrities or civilians over there, you never applaud either.
I have things on my mind.
I know it. You're a very preoccupied guy.
Sometimes I don't know how I can even sit here. I have such tensions. You can understand that.
No.
Yes. I'll try to remember
the gestures
needed for this role.
Right. Would you greet our current champion, Linda Morzinski? Thank you. Oh, well done. Well done.
Well, thank you.
Linda's won a pretty good bundle of money. She has $5,700 to her credit, and she's going to have a go at another big lump of money, aren't you?
Right.
Okay, well, she won the game just as we time expired last time, and she'll go for the audience match right after this. Walking and turning. Ah, hello there. Now, here we are once again with Linda Morzinski. She has $5,700. It's the second game she's won, and she's going to have another go at the audience match. Shall we?
Why not? Right.
Okay. She talks too much. That's one of her main problems. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Get into blank. Now, Linda, if you match the answer they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, you get $250. And for the third, $100. and three of the six will help.
Richard.
Something I've always managed to do, get into trouble.
Really?
Yeah.
You sweet, innocent looking.
I know. I enjoy it, of course.
Backward fellow that you are, little country boy from the south of England, unsophisticated, you get into trouble.
Oh, shit.
All right, who else you want to?
Betty.
Well, I don't even want to discuss why I'm saying get into bed.
Oh, all right. Okay.
That's how I get into trouble.
I want to discuss it.
Yes.
Brett.
Well.
She's thinking, as you can see. You can't see her face. When you can't see her face, she's thinking.
Oh, I think that stinks. Oh, that's terrible. I say, why don't you get into something more comfortable?
Get into something more comfortable?
It's slipping, too. Just because you never heard it in your own life, get it right.
I never had to get into something more comfortable. I was already there.
So there they are. Get into something more comfortable. Get into trouble and get into bed are the three that offered by the celebrities. Now, you have the option here of choosing one of those or thinking up one of your own. What is your pleasure?
Bed.
You know, it isn't often on national television that you can say to a girl, what is your pleasure? And she says, bed. And and the lights don't blow out and the camera doesn't blow up and all that. Okay, Linda, we'll find a bed for you, honey. Whoops, there. Let's go over here and look for the $100 response. You got it right off the bat. Get into bed right off the bat. Well, we'll find out what's up there now. Let's look at the $250 number. Get into it. What does that mean, Ira?
Get into the swing of it.
Get into the... Oh, I see. Get into
it. Get with it.
It's get with it. Yeah, that's what I thought it was. All right. What do you think is up in the big one?
Trouble.
Get into shape.
Trouble.
Okay. Go.
Did you notice how silent it was when I said trouble?
Yes. Yeah.
That's probably why you didn't choose it, right?
That's right. She let the audience influence them. That's exactly what she did. And apparently they're not too bright, are they? No. They're not very bright, but they are friendly. You can tell that. Now listen, Linda. You've won the $100. That means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $1,000, and we're going to give you the money if you'll choose one celebrity and give us an exact match.
Richard.
All right, Richard, here we go. Ready?
Ready.
This is it. Good luck to you, Linda. $1,000 better than nothing, isn't it? Crowded blank. Crowded blank. Crowded blank. Linda, give us the answer that Richard has written. We give you $1,000 for one word. Crowded.
Audience.
Audience. Yes. Can we start all over? All right. Can I put it back and come up? No, I can't do that. All right, let's turn now and find out what Richard has on the card. Crowded.
I glanced at you across a crowded room.
Oh, yeah. You know that song from South Pacific? Yes, one and a chanted to the evening. It's a marvelous song there. Well, yes.
That was not a request, Brett.
Oh, well, I got it.
Linda, you picked up another $100. You got $5,800, and you're going to play another game with Marge Gassman. And here she comes right now. There you go. Marge, you know Linda?
Yep.
We welcome Marge Gassman. And we'd like to find out a little bit about her. Would you tell us about Marge Gassman? You know her well, don't you?
Well, I think so.
Okay.
I was born here in Southern California.
Yeah.
I moved to Northern California when I got remarried And when I remarried, I created kind of a problem because now my son is my stepson. He's married to his stepsister. And my daughter... Oh, you figure it out. You can figure it out. And we also...
Oh, by that one more time.
Yes, stepsister. Yes, is married to her stepbrother.
No, her stepson, who is
stepson,
my son.
Who is your son. By the previous marriage.
No.
Oh, Betty.
Oh. You got all that now?
No, he's my real son, and he's married to his stepsister now.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm
real
sorry
son.
Our time is up. You're going to have to leave now, Marge.
Okay.
Well, hang around here for a minute while we do a commercial, then we'll play a game after this. Here we go. All right, now this is the first round, Marge, and we ask you, as usual, to make a selection of A or B.
I'll have B.
B it is for Marge Gassman. Nerdocrumbesia is the world's most underdeveloped country. Their Air Force consists of one bomb and a blank. I remember it's first round, anything that comes to your mind.
Anything is okay, right?
Yes. One bomb and a blank. One bomb and a blank. Okay, she's writing. Here it is. Nerdocrumbesia is the world's most underdeveloped country. Their Air Force consists of one bomb...
And one airplane.
And one airplane. See, that ain't going to get you there.
Yeah, I know it.
We realize that when we said one bomb, we needed some sort of delivery system for that bomb. But an airplane is a conventional delivery system for that sort of thing. We were thinking of something unconventional to deliver that bomb, weren't we, David?
I was taken back to the days of the catapult.
To the catapult.
Storming the walls
one
with
bomb
and a rubber band.
And a rubber band. Isn't that good? That was very good, David.
Well, now, there are other ways that you can get a little bomb going.
Sure.
You just put a little firecracker under, then they go,
one
pa-chung!
Bomb and a firecracker. They go, pa-chung, right.
Grum-chuck. I'm an old woman.
No, you're not. Charles?
I don't go that far back to the catapult days, but I could remember my own youth.
Yeah,
11 years ago in Hartford.
In Hartford.
Rubber band when you made a little airplane.
Rubber band. No, she says
try
one
not
bomb.
To have a rally.
One
keep
airplane.
Down the hand, please.
Unlikely that we're going to get a match for Marge Gassman, but we must go through the formality, Elaine. One bomb and a.
And pop rocks.
And pop rocks.
Very good answer.
All right.
That's funny.
Oh, pop rocks are marvelous.
They're wonderful.
What are they?
They're terrible.
Oh,
they're little candies, and they're made of carbon dioxide, and you put them in their mouth, and they...
Really?
Like that.
Oh, they're marvelous.
I've never
had
them.
Or you
we'll
take
have
a shower
later.
And sprinkle them on your body.
Come with me.
Later.
Come with me. You're going right now. I want a demonstration of what you're talking about.
Later.
Oh, all right.
You know what's wrong with you? You had a demonstration in Encino. You've just forgotten.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes.
Probably don't remember me. What was the question?
Nerdocrumbesia, the world's most underdeveloped country. Air Force consists of one bomb and a...
Kite.
Wouldn't that be unconventional?
Yep.
Show us something unconventional. One bomb and a...
And a bird. I'll show
in
you.
In a kitchen, yeah. See how easy it is? Now, let's see what we've got for Linda here. Sam has no sense of humor.
Oh, why not?
Sam has no sense of... In fact, he says his favorite comedian is blank. Sam has no sense of humor. In fact, he says his favorite comedian is blank.
Comedian?
Yeah. Well, obviously, what they're after here is someone...
Without a sense of humor.
Who has no sense of humor.
Sam has no sense of humor. In fact, he says his favorite comedian is... blank.
Don't talk about it.
Well, I do my best.
You know, your microphone could be open.
Oh, okay.
Leave him alone. Now, you leave him alone.
I like it.
It's okay.
I'm giggling because I think it's mirth-provoking and wonderful.
Linda, Sam has no sense of humor. In fact, he says his favorite comedian is...
Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell. That's good. Apparently, the audience agrees with you, Linda, that Howard Cosell is about as unfunny as you can get. What do you say?
I was thinking along the Family Mortician.
That's pretty unfunny, too. See, that's got a good response there.
Well, you know how many laughs Gerald Ford gave
us. Oh, yes. Oh, he was a million laughs now, wasn't he? What do you say?
What CBS says every night.
What?
And now the comedy of Walter Cronkite.
Oh, yes, good. Oh, I laugh at him almost every night.
Right.
What do you say?
Another funny man, Jimmy Carter.
Oh, yes. And Richard.
We're eliminating everybody.
Yes.
Jim Neighbors.
Jim Neighbors. Yeah.
Golly.
We're offending everyone we can think of. Hello there.
You left out one.
You left out one? But please help us cover all bases here, will you? We don't want to leave out anyone.
I mean, just thinking about him just breaks me up. Richard Nixon.
Oh, so funny. He was a million laughs. I'll never forget Richard, what's his name. Okay, so there we are at the end of round one, no score. And that's the way it is, you see. But round two is coming up, so hurry back.
Today's consolation prizes are, first, the Hoover Celebrity 2 with more carpet cleaning power than any other make canister. Another good reason why America trusts Hoover. And add color, character, and charm to your home with fireproof, inexpensive Z-Brick, America's most popular brick wall covering, the last word in wall covering. And the Colonel's finger-licking good chicken and an insulated bag to keep things cool. It's nice to feel so good about a meal, Kentucky Fried Chicken. And a hot lather machine and a supply of new flavor formula Search. If you took a Search now, your breath would still be fresh in half an hour. Search keeps on working even after 30 minutes. Golly gee, on we go with the Match Game star, Gene Raver.
Thank you, Johnny O. Here we go. Round two. Marge?
B.
Marge Gassman says she wants B. She didn't match anybody in the first round, so everybody plays the second round. Did you hear about the mad scientist who crossed a Playboy bunny with a Volkswagen rabbit?
With a what?
Crossed a Playboy bunny with a Volkswagen rabbit. Now he's got the only car in the world with blank.
You see, you asked that question last
Mad
week
science.
In variation of that, and I got it all wrong.
Right. Well, try it again. We're going to keep doing it until you get it right.
With a Playboy bunny with a
Playboy bunny and a Volkswagen rabbit. Now he's got the, what's it say? Now he's got the only car in the world with blank, right? It's an easy one, I think. For a round one, I think it's a very easy one.
So cute. We're going to have the best time tonight.
Yes, of course.
Of course. Number
C2. Me neither, hon. You're not alone.
Marge?
Oh, look. See if anyone wants that cruddy answer
right
he's
one.
About to come up with.
Thanks.
Well, now, they're both writing an answer, so I guess we're just about ready. Did you hear about the mad scientist who crossed a Playboy bunny with a Volkswagen rabbit? Now he's got the only car in the world with...
boobs.
Boobs.
Hey, Mark!
Biggest headlights in town. What do you say?
I said a tail on both ends.
A tail on both ends.
Don't they have a tail?
Oh, that's right. The bunnies have those little cotton tails, right.
Yes.
Right.
Here comes Peter Cottontail tapping down the rabbit trail. I said a cottontail.
A cottontail.
Yeah, those little girls, they have that little thing.
Yeah.
You'd like not to call it anything else, but yes. You've got to call it a cottontail.
And you can't touch it.
You can't? Have you ever tried?
No, it's against the rules. What do you say?
Would UCLA love to get a hold of that and experiment with the entire psyche?
I've chosen Boob Bust Bumpers.
Boob Bust Bumpers. Okay, so there's one for Marge. The only car in the world with...
You said there's one for Marge. I have another one for her.
That makes four for her. Or two, depending on how you look at it. How do you look at it?
Well, I say cleavage, the same thing.
Cleavage! That's three for Marge. Marge Gassman wants you to show her your... Oh, she did, yes. So that's four for her. Now, Linda, you'll have a little catching up to do, but you could surpass her if you match five of our celebrities. Everyone plays. It's the final round. The bounty hunter said, I got a strange job today. I'm sorry. I'm going to have to clean out this saloon and get another mob in here. You're just too half-hearted about your job. This guy said, I got a strange job today. I'm going after a man with a price on his head and a woman with a price on her blank. Okay. Okay. Going after a man with a price on his head and a woman with a price on her blank.
Oh?
Okay. Linda, you're ready. Bounty hunter said, I got a strange job today. I'm going after a man with a price on his head and a woman with a price on her blank.
Buns.
On her buns. She went to the opposite end.
Well, I think, yes, from top to bottom.
Right. That's what she did.
From top to tush.
Oh, yeah, that's one for her. Score is now 4-1. You must match three more to achieve a tie. Brett?
I always thought she was that great, famous Western rug maker hooker. I said body.
Body. No match there. Charles, buns is what we're looking for.
Excellent acting as the bounty man.
Oh,
excellent.
Thank you.
Didn't go by me. It went by the others. It was subtle.
Yeah.
Like a George C. Scott. Excellent. Tail.
There it is. Another one for her. Score is now 4-2. I'm a going after a man with a price on his head and a woman with a price on her...
Dress. No, I said body.
Body. Score remains 4-2. You must match two remaining ones to stay in the game. Richard.
Body.
Body. So that means Marge Gassman wins the game. And there we have Derriere. While she's making her way here, we'll say goodbye to Linda, who is not leaving here empty-handed. She has a total of $5,800. Congratulations, Linda. Thank you. Goodbye. We'll spin her off, and we'll spin a message for you, and then we'll come back to you. I'm Gene Raber. Join us next time for Match Game 78. Thank you. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Trotman production. This program was edited for broadcast. ready to match the stars from Lou Grant, Robert Walden, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from MASH, Loretta Switz, from Carter Country, Richard Paul, and Mary Wicks, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rivers!
And how are you?
Thank you, friend.
All right. Thank you very much for joining us. What a joy to see you. Robert, we welcome you.
I'm sure you're
familiar with this wonderful looking young fellow here from the Lou Grant Show. Nice to have you with us. First time around.
Thank you, Gene.
Thank you. Yay. Loretta, it's been so long since you've been here.
I know.
And you've changed
it.
Thank you. You've changed the color of your lipstick since you've been here last.
You noticed.
See how observant I am?
And
you, your lipstick.
I changed my lips.
And what did you change?
We're not going into that.
Oh, all right. Little kiss, Mary?
Why not?
Okay.
Oh, I love it. Get your hands off that fat lady.
Oh, all right. I guess you're all ready for fun and games here, so let's welcome Rudy Romero, Jr. and Mary Jane Vesladol. Rudy here. We'll refresh your memories. It seems so long since yesterday, doesn't it? Rudy's a cop, right?
Yes.
LAPD.
LAPD, right.
And are you a uniform policeman?
Not with this hair, no.
Oh, really?
I work special problems unit. It's a crime suppression unit.
Yeah. And any special area?
Right here in Hollywood.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I won't walk the streets there. And you, my dear, would you refresh our memory on where you're from and what you do with your life?
I'm originally from Minnesota.
Yes.
And I moved to Hermosa Beach 4 years ago, and I'm a waitress there.
And you're happy there?
I sure am.
Do you get on the beach very often? You don't have a suntan.
No, I don't.
You don't? Oh.
Not at all.
Well, I hope your tips are great. Good luck to both of you.
Thank you.
Waitresses can make a great deal of money with...
Really?
Good tips there. Okay. Let's do a little business. Go to black here. Don't bother me with your... Hello. Oh! Here we go. Mary Jane, you may have A or B.
B, please.
B it is. This is a brand new game, and everyone will play. In the delivery room, the doctor said, this baby is going to be an executive. It's the first time I ever saw a baby wearing a blank diaper. The label on your dress is showing.
That's not what you said on the airplane last night when we
Quiet.
Were flying.
Really?
Last night?
Last night.
Flying.
We flew together from Boston to Los Angeles. Yay! Okay, Mary Jane, here we go. In the delivery room, the doctor said, this baby is going to be an executive. It's the first time I ever saw a baby wearing a blank diaper.
Oval?
Oval? The Oval Room of the White House is an executive office, and that's why you thought that.
Right.
It's a good idea, but I don't think anybody's going to say it over here.
That's heavy, the Oval Office. Did you
get
it?
Right, yeah. I got it. Now, Robert came up with a brilliant answer. Show it to him, Robert.
Yeah, it was either vested, plaid, or...
button down, you know? Executives wear those button down shirts there.
Now you can button down.
I don't think it's too cute. All right, now what did you finally...
I said dark gray.
Dark gray is okay. All right.
Don't you boo me.
Charles may have the definitive answer.
I do have the definitive
answer.
He might.
Answer.
Yes.
Executive is the, what
executive
is the word
is
you call it?
Operative word.
Operative, I can't speak up caps. Operative. What is the most important executive? The what executive?
The chief executive.
Oh.
Right.
Now, a diaper is square or triangular.
Right.
If it was oval, it would be rather hard to choose where to put the pins.
Right.
So I would like to congratulate her and myself at the definitive answer.
Oh! Uh-huh. Well, Charles, we are dealing with different lexicons here. The definitive answer is not always the correct answer, and vice versa. What did you say?
Well, I said gray flannel.
Gray flannel. Now, there's the definitive answer.
Then why did it get such a mild applause?
And a buzzer.
Because they're too young to remember the movie called The Gray Flannel.
What does that mean?
Nothing. I'll kiss your sore toe again later there. Okay. All right. Anything you say. How about you?
Well, I hate to be a copycat, but I said the man in the gray flannel diaper.
Yeah. Remember the movie or what? The gray flannel suit. Right. It was about the advertising industry, executives there. What'd you say, Mary?
Don't use my real name in front of the law.
Oh.
Call me Isabella.
Okay, Isabella.
Gray flannel.
Gray flannel. Well, we have three of those down there. Now let's see how Rudy Romero does. You want A or B?
I think I'll take A.
A. Okay.
Don't Susie. Try and make up to the fuzz.
Susie, the Siamese twin, said, "It's tough being a Siamese twin. Once my sister had a date. She had fun, but I got blank."
Oh, I have the most wonderful language in the world.
Well, put it down.
I can't.
That's the very chair that Lou Grant sits in occasionally, better known as Ed Asner. Ready, Rudy?
Yes.
Emmy winner.
Right. Susie the Siamese twin said, "It's tough being a Siamese twin. Once my sister had a date, she had fun, but I got blank."
The only thing I could think of was Siamese, like Siamese cat, and she got the fleas.
Watch it, he's the law. Watch it.
Can't think of anything else, eh?
No.
No. Okay. All right, Rudy. Okay. Yep. Here we go, Robert.
Fleas.
Fleas. That's his answer, fleas. He was thinking of Siamese cats, you see.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah. I see.
I'll tell you right up front, it's a dumb answer. He's not going to match anybody. Let's just get on with it and reveal him and be done.
But I'd stay off his beat if I were you.
Stay off of Hollywood Boulevard.
Go.
I said pregnant.
Pregnant.
That was a problem.
It's all right. Yeah. That seems to please them.
I think that's a very cute answer.
I think it's a wonderful answer.
I think it's...
She had fun, but I got pregnant. Yes.
I said she got all tuckered out.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
She had fun, but I got all tuckered out. Okay, Chuck?
I said pregnant also.
All right, two of those, yeah.
One more bright man on the panel.
That seems to be the definitive answer, Loretta.
She had fun, and I got into trouble.
Oh, that's cute.
See, yeah. She does come from a gentler time, doesn't
yes,
she?
Yes, yes. Indeed.
Nice. We just say it. Pregnant.
Right, right, straight out. You, Mary?
She had fun. The other one got tired.
Tired. Okay.
Sorry to
so there we are at the end of round one, 1-0 score. Fair. Mary Jane is ahead by 1 point. Round two coming up right after this. Let us carry on now. Go to round two here. Ask Mary Jane once again her selection.
B again, please.
B again. One person does not play. That's Chuck. Bill said, "I just saw the world's strangest fisherman. Instead of bait, he hung his blank over the side of the boat."
Life is just a bowl of cherries.
Okay, Ethel.
Take it, Ethel.
Isn't she wonderful to sit 5 hours on next to on a plane? Don't you get a lot of rest? Don't you find the voice is a little grating in a small cabin?
No.
America, I want you to know you weren't trying. We had a swell time.
We
had one drink. And I looked over all set for a nice long conversation after dinner. It was a...
Mary Jane, ready. Bill said, "I just saw the world's strangest fisherman. Instead of bait, he hung his blank over the side of the boat."
His leg.
His leg. Okay, dragged his leg over the side of the boat. Nothing wrong with that. Perfectly good answer. Any bodily appendage, arm, leg, anything like that. What'd you say, Robert?
I'm going to get as much mail as you're going to get on the last statement.
His wife. His wife, okay? Hung his wife over the side of the boat. I guess she'd attract a shark or two. What do you say?
I didn't say wife.
You did.
Because you know me, I'm very militant and all that stuff.
Yes.
About soldiers and sailors and Marines. I said his oldest child. I don't want him.
Oh, really? Mary Jane's looking for the answer. Leg, Loretta. What do you say? He hung his leg over the side of the boat.
I feel very militant also, but I felt sure that she was going to say wife, thereby attracting many fish because the wife is so really wonderful and terrific and...
Oh, I see. Yes. Okay.
Well, right. I said, first of all, he fed her an anchovy pizza, and he tossed his wife over the side.
All right, Mary, looking for a little leg here.
You think we ought to get some help for Brett? I mean, her oldest child, well, he put his wife over there.
Wife.
He couldn't stand it.
Did you think of that, Mary Jane, and rejected it? Okay, Rudy, here we go. Remember the rule? You usually say the first thing that comes to your head.
My goodness, what's this one? Oh, my.
Now, hear this. Did you hear that they're making a movie, a sequel to the movie Logan's Run? In this one, Logan weighs 400 pounds. They're calling it Logan's Blank. Sequel to the movie Logan's Run. In this one, Logan weighs 400 pounds. They're calling it Logan's Blank.
Another weight is joking.
You have a small body compared to...
You need a new optometrist.
Let's just see if you got the idea. Here. Yes! Very good. Excellent. Okay, here we go, Rudy. Now, here's the way it is, Rudy. You need one to tie, two to win. Here we go.
Chatting.
They're making a sequel to the movie Logan's Run, and this one, Logan weighs 400 pounds. They're calling it Logan's...
How about Roll?
How about Roll? Okay.
How about roll?
He said roll.
I have to confess, I never understood policemen's mentality, so I said crawl. Logan's crawl.
Calling it Logan's crawl if he were big, rotund,
what
obese.
Don't you run me. I.
Okay, Mary and Lauren.
I tell you, it's time to get help.
Show us the answer.
I said Logan's landing field.
Oh, that is rotten answer.
You think I should stop reading and start watching television and going to the movies or something?
Chuck.
Logan's Ton.
Yeah! Logan's Ton. It's not bad, little play. Ton, Logan Run, Ton, Ton, Toon, Tim.
Really good. Logan's Blubber. I think that question stinks. Yes, I do, too.
She doesn't like the question there. Jake, did you write that one? No, who wrote that one? You don't know.
Sure.
I'll bet you do. Okay, what do you say?
I can't say I'm terrifically happy with the question, either. It was trying to run, but it just came out a waddle.
Waddle. Now, that's good. That's excellent. Excellent response. But you must match Mary to achieve a tie and stay in the game, Rudy. Mary?
You know I'd like to, Rudy. Best in the world, but I said creep.
Logan's creep, so that means Mary Jane wins the game. Rudy, sorry you didn't win more money.
That's the way it goes.
$100 coming your way. A pleasure to meet a member of the LAPD, Rudy Romero Jr., ladies and gentlemen. We'll spin him off and spin a commercial just for you. Okay, Johnny O, here we go with Jane. It's her first shot at the big money here. Good luck to her. Jane, we pulled a studio audience not too long ago and said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank Hall. If you match the answer they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, $250. And then for matching the third, $100. And now three of the stars will assist Mary Jane. Whom do you call on?
Brett, please.
Yoo-haw!
Charles?
Hire a haul.
What was that?
Yoo-haul. Row haul, long haul. Oh,
long
that's good.
Haul.
I got an idea. Long haul.
Long haul.
All right.
And Mary, please.
Overhaul.
Yeah. Overhaul, long haul, and U-Haul are the three. Mary Jane, do you want one of those, or would you like to give us one of your own?
I'll take a U-Haul.
Oh, U-Haul is what you want. Let's find out if it's up there and so where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 number. Overhaul is Mary's answer. Okay. Let's go up the ladder and look at the $250 response. Long haul. There we are. We're rolling right along. Chuck's answer via Brett. And now let's see if Brett's answer is on top there. Slide it. Yeah! U-Haul. Okay. Now, Mary Jane, you've won the $500, which means the least you can play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. However, if you have a good lucky spin of the star wheel, you can double your money and play for $10,000. Wow. Let's see how it goes. It must make one revolution go. If the blue light stays on, that means that it fell in the double area. And it looks pretty good for her. There it is. She's got it. Playing for $10,000 with Brett Summers. Good luck, Mary Jane. Ready, Brett?
Huh?
You're ready. You are ready.
No.
Here we go. This is what it says here. Blank sale. S-A-L-E. Blank sale. Or blank sale. Blank sale. Blank sale. Have you got yours already? Oh, she made up her mind very quickly. Brett took a little time. She wanted to make sure she tries to match you and vice versa. Mary Jane, if you give us the answer that Brett's written on the card, we give you $10,000.
For sale.
For sale. Simple, straightforward. To the point. Excellent answer. So what do you say, Brett?
I'm going to kill myself.
Why?
Because I put for sale, I put white sale, and I ended up with fire sale.
Fire sale. Oh.
Bad.
Well, I'm sorry I didn't win the money, Mary Jane. You've picked up an additional amount of $500, giving you a total of $600, and you're going to meet another player right now, so let's welcome Debbie Rich. Here she comes. Debbie, you know Mary Jane.
Yeah.
Well, we welcome you, and we'd like to find out a little bit about you, Debbie.
Yes, I live in Cudahy, California, with my husband of 12 years this week, and my son who is 9, and my daughter who is 4, and I'm a sales service secretary.
Okay, Debbie, we wish you the best of luck.
Thank
and ask you to make a decision here about A or B.
B, please.
B it is. We're off and running with another game. Harry said I went to a restaurant that was so rotten when I dropped my spoon in the soup, it blanked. I went to a restaurant that was so rotten when I dropped my spoon in the soup, it blanked. I dropped my spoon in the soup.
It's hard to
say that.
You have to go in and have them fit.
Okay.
You can't get the teeth by mail.
Right.
You've got to go in and let them fit.
It's the last time I go to Newberry's for my teeth.
Either that or stop flying with Brett.
Right. No, she made the time pass so fast. It was a wonderful trip. All right, Robert's ready, so we'll go over here to Debbie Rich and ask her what her response is. Harry said I went to a restaurant that was so rotten when I dropped my spoon in the soup. It blanked. Ready? Go.
Dissolved?
Dissolved! Very good! Perfect answer. That sweet little lady came up with the perfect answer.
Woman of my own intelligence. What are you busy tonight with those kids and the husband and everything? That's what I wrote. Dissolved.
Dissolved! Very good. Okay, Brett.
I said it turned green.
Turned green would be another possibility.
I said it bent.
It bent. It's close to being dissolved, but not quite.
What did it do?
It bent.
Bent. Oh.
Well, it was, you know, there was a lot of something in the soup too hot.
Mine bounced.
It bounced. Another good one there.
All right, Richard. I think she's been eating in my restaurant. Dissolved.
Dissolved. 2 for Debbie.
Are you busy tonight?
You make it 3 for Debbie, Mary.
I don't want to have any nonsense.
No nonsense.
Dissolved and melted are the same thing, right?
Yes.
Right?
Right. Three for her. Hang around, we got one for you. Right now we have this for you. Listen, may I remind all of you to watch this sweet-looking lady on a wonderful show called MASH. Yeah. Love you. Don't forget to look for the mayor of Carter Country. And Lou Grant. Okay.
Hello.
Now, you're not a Cub reporter. You're a seasoned reporter, aren't you?
I'm the best writer on the whole paper.
Oh, you are. You are indeed.
But nobody likes me.
We
Brett,
love you.
Sweetheart, how many series did we turn down just last week alone? 9? We turned down all the series. They call us constantly.
That's true. I keep calling them, but the things I turn down, I call them.
I'm Gene Rayburn. Join us next time for Match Game 78. Goodbye.
Speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast. The stars, Joe Santos, Brett Summers, Dick Martin, Ava Gabor, McLean Stevenson, and for Mr. Merlin, Elaine Joyce, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Isn't it a daring combination?
I love it.
Smash it.
What do you mean, what is sticking out where?
You know you're getting his
big cat. He's a gun guy.
That's his pecs.
He's walking
right,
iron.
Pec girls there.
That's right.
Let's say hello to Stan Teague and Carolyn Jackson. Applause, applause. Carolyn's going to be married soon.
That's right, 6 weeks.
And she's a physical exercise person.
Yes.
What could you do for me, Carolyn?
Oh, not too much. You look like you're doing pretty good yourself.
I'm 10 pounds overweight. I've got to do some exercise, but we'll talk about it in my dressing room later if your boyfriend isn't here.
There goes 6 pounds right there.
Right, right. All right, Stan Teague.
Yes,
where are you from again?
Texas.
That's right.
Without the draw.
Right. No draw.
Right.
No draw team, they call
it. Texas.
Right.
All right, here we go. This is round one of game number two. And Carolyn, you have a choice of A or B.
I'll try B this time.
All right.
Okay.
Horrible Hannah is really horrible. After she washes her hair with beer, she puts blanks in her ears. She's really horrible. After she washes her hair with beer, she puts blanks. I'm the guy who wears the snappy clothes and has a steak hole in his hair.
Why don't you go talk to the guests?
It's all right, McLean. I've already called and told them to get the geriatric suite ready.
Carol, horrible hand is really horrible. After she washes her hair with beer, she puts blanks in her ears.
Pretzels.
Pretzels are good. I know you don't drink, Joe.
You know, I'm really good at this game. That's what I said.
Aha!
That's
it. Hey, Joe, one in a row.
One
All right.
in a row.
One in a row, right.
Where were you when I needed you, Joe?
You didn't say pretzels?
No,
What'd
I said
you say?
Cans.
Cans. She put cans in her ear. Oh, she put some beer cans in her ear. All right.
One more for pretzels.
Pretzels. Got a way to go, Jake.
I like Brett's remark, cans. That would be nice earrings.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah. I wrote pretzels.
You did. Three for Carolyn. You make it four.
I can make it four and will, sir. Pretzels.
Pretzels, very good.
You would make it five.
I put down recycled pretzels.
You got five. Very unusual for a first round question. There it is. Now, Stan, you got some catching up to do. Ugly Alfreda is so ugly. Well, she just got a job in Hollywood as a stand-in for blank.
What?
She got a job in Hollywood as a stand-in for blank. That's how ugly she was.
Yeah. And you
don't Guy sure knows how to live, doesn't he?
Oh, Lord, I feel like a little weed in the garden of life.
A pauper in paradise.
Ugly Alfreda, so ugly she just got a job in Hollywood as a stand-in for blank.
Lassie.
Lassie.
Lassie's beautiful.
But she's a dog.
Not a dog, it's a person.
Oh, all right.
I'm really good.
Oh! Lassie. Lassie. He's good at the set. I don't believe it either.
I don't believe it.
All right. Let's get it. Oh, thank you, Joe.
That's
two in a row, Joe.
Yep.
It is. All right, the ACPC gets a hold of you two.
What did you say? I did not hear what Ava said.
I don't know what I said.
Tell me about the darling. What did
you call a dog?
She didn't say what?
No, she didn't say anything.
No, I didn't see that. I said King Kong.
King Kong. Lassie's the answer we're looking for.
I said Ernest Borgnine.
Aha!
No offense, Ernie.
Only kidding.
Only kidding, Ernie. What do you say, Ava?
I said Elephant Man.
The Elephant Man.
Yeah. I stole it from my plane.
Oh. Yeah. Now, you see, the trouble with that is, see, he can't do the joke now. We should have called
right.
on him first, then you second. What was it? What would you have said?
Cut! Oh, boy. I said...
Ugly Alfreda, so ugly she just got a job in Hollywood as a stand-in for...
Spider-Man.
So 5-1 is the score.
Carolyn,
you have a choice of A or B.
I'll stick with B.
B, you have to go first. One person plays. Brett, are you ready?
One person.
Ready for what, dear?
You're the only one who plays.
Why?
Everyone matched in the previous round.
Why only a bit in
such a mess.
No, it's a makeup.
What the hell is this? Is a massage parlor? Stop that. Hello.
Hello, darling.
Pay attention. Arnold the astronomer.
Pay attention.
You're the only one. Arnold the astronomer said to his wife,
yeah.
Come quick, I've discovered two new moons. And his wife said, no, you haven't. You're pointing the telescope at my blank.
Oh. Oh. Play.
That's a perfect one for Brett.
Hey, Brett.
Do you have an answer?
Boobs.
Boobs.
What did you say?
Well, you know, someone could throw a moon. You could have the other answer there, but she said boobs.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought it was a shoe-in, darling. I said buns.
Buns.
That, isn't that boobs?
No, buns are not boobs.
Hey, maybe in Hungary they are.
Maybe in Hungary they are.
I don't know.
So you have a chance to catch up later. Right now, this for you, if you please. Oh, last chance, Stan. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
4-tie and 5-win. Joe, you do the layout. Everyone else plays.
I know.
Are you ready, Dad? You're on the air.
You didn't tell me.
Yeah, I am telling you now. The captain of the firing squad said, that condemned man has a lot of nerve. Here we are about to shoot him, and he's blanking on the wall. Here we go, Stan. The captain of the firing squad said, that condemned man has a lot of nerve. Here we are about to shoot him, and he's blanking on the wall.
Do we play it safe or?
Yeah. Yes.
No, I think.
Doing number one?
No,
is that a nice way to put it?
I told you I should have.
daytime show. That was on all of our minds. And we
all right, Brett, may we see it, please?
Trying to remember. I heard that expression.
Yes, well, I don't want to go into it, April. Let's just get out.
I can't say it.
Right. Writing graffiti on the wall.
He was writing graffiti on the wall.
I said taking a nap.
Wonderful answer.
All right, that means Carolyn Jackson wins again. Let the rest of you down here.
Writing. Writing.
All right, come on down, Carolyn. Now, Stan won the first game, and he won a total of $500, and we congratulate him for that, and thank him for being here on Match Game. Stan T. All right, my dear, here we go.
Now, that's a good figure, Gene. Look at this girl. That's a figure.
Well, yeah, that's her business, physical fitness. Yes.
Looks great.
Yes.
There's no use to feel it around. It looks great.
It really is. What's your waist size?
25 and a half.
25 and a half. Hips?
Well, I can match 36? You in that, but not
and,
today. Biceps?
Biceps, yes. All right, let's find out what happens here. Good luck to you. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Sit up blank.
Oh,
sit
good.
Sit up blank.
I have a good
one. Oh, Ava.
Exercises.
Sit up exercises. All right.
Oh,
no.
No
good?
Sit up straight.
Sit up and listen.
Sit up and listen, sit up straight, and sit up exercises. Choose one of those or think up one of your own.
Sit up straight.
All right. Let's see if sit up straight is up there, and if so, where may we see the $100 number, please? Sit up and take notice. Let's take a look at the next one, if you please. Sit up and listen, sit up.
That's not this feeling.
Sit up and beg. Well, none of your answers are up
not
there.
Not very exciting answers.
Sit up straight. Here we go.
That
yeah. Yeah. Now we have to make the decision whether you're going to play for $5,000 or $10,000. So step up there, give the wheel a spin. It must make one revolution, and good luck to you. Here we go. Dick Martin.
No double.
$5,000 with Dick Martin. If you would, please. Good luck to you. Here we go. Blank. Commission. COMMISSION. Blank commission. Have you got one?
Yes, I do.
All right, good luck to you. Your job is to match Dick Martin. Let's see if you do for $5,000. What do you say?
Sales commission.
Sales commission. Why, that sounds reasonable to me. Let's see what he says.
Being in show business, I had thought of 10% commission or agent's commission.
Yeah.
But I finally said sales.
Oh! $5,500. Congratulations to you, Carolyn. Goodbye, my dear. Follow that tall, skinny guy over there. Here come Mary Tomlinson and Kermit Vinson. Hey! Hello, Mary and Kermit.
You're out.
Welcome to the two of you. We've had a lot of excitement here because the lady won a big bundle of money, and we're very happy for her. Now, Kermit, let's find out about you.
Hi, Gene. I'm Kermit Vincent. I come from a town, Mankato, in southern Minnesota.
Mankato, Minnesota.
Right. I've been in L.A. about a year. I really love it a lot, and I soon hope to take the acting world by storm.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
You're an actor.
I definitely am.
Yeah.
Great. Good.
Well, some of us are trying. So am I, but look at what I'm doing for a living. Here. All right, Mary,
best.
Let's find out about you.
My name is Mary Tomlinson. I retired in 1979 from the federal government as communications director. I'm a grandmother of six.
Aw, how cute.
And I play tennis, go to senior citizen dances, play water volleyball, and I've come close to death three times. So I take each day as it comes, and I'm having a ball.
And a way to go, Mary. Good for you. We'll be back in a moment right after this. Here we go. Game one, round one. Kermit A or B?
B for Barbara, please.
All right. Dumb Donald is really dumb.
How dumb is he?
He heard there was a Bush in the White House, so he sent the president blank. Man doesn't dare to stand up.
You're ready. Elaine, you're ready.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Dumb Donald's really dumb. He heard there was a Bush in the White House, so he sent the president blank.
A gardener.
A gardener.
A what?
A gardener.
Hey, gardener. Gardener's not too terrific.
Well, I figured manure was apropos.
Manure was apropos.
Definitely.
Any kind of fertilizer would be all right.
Well, I guess it's everywhere in Washington, regardless of who's there. Horse manure.
Right. Yeah, they've
horse
got a lot.
Bueno.
Oh, they've got it down
they've
there.
Got a corner on the market.
Yeah. Oh. Really wouldn't have to send any to the White House. It's
not
loaded
really.
With it all by itself there. What do you say?
I said the fertilizer.
Fertilizer? You're on the same track. Everyone seems to be saying the same thing
but
here,
McLean. But that's what you use for a bush to grow.
That's true, yes.
I thought I'd tell you in case you didn't know.
Oh, yes, I use all that stuff.
But, as you well know, if your bush gets too big, you have pruning shears.
Pruning shears.
Of course.
No, they send the pruning shears for Mr. Hay.
Yes. All right, Elaine.
I happen to like everyone in the White House, Bush included. I said pruning shears.
Uh-huh. All right. So, Mary, let's see what we have for you here. You have the A question, which reads, Fred said, my wife is the world's worst cook. Last night for dinner, she served southern fried blank. World's worst cook. Don't yawn.
Have a good time, McLean.
Put your food at camp.
Yes.
Can I get some of that?
That's a sword to beat, no?
Right. All right, let him finish writing now so we can get on with it. All right.
Sorry.
Fred said, my wife is the world's worst cook. Last night for dinner, she served southern fried blank.
Black-eyed peas.
World's worst cook.
Southern fried. You don't fry black-eyed peas.
Oh, that's right. You boil them. All right. All
right,
Joe.
Oh, no, he's got it.
I got it.
He's got it.
That was close.
One would bet $100 he'd had black eyed peas.
I was going to say watermelon.
Oh, that's a good answer. Southern fried watermelon. That's excellent. What have you got, Brett?
Southern fried mud pie.
Southern fried mud. Another good one. All right, Dick.
Southern fried water.
Oh, tough. You're doing it the hard
fried
way.
Fried water.
Yep. All right, Ava. Last night for dinner, she served southern fried...
Mud.
What took you so long, McLean?
I didn't know how to spell milk duds.
That's good. Oh, good answer.
I said mud, too.
Mud. All right. So there we are,
well,
Mary. Score is tied, zip to zip.
What?
And since he went first last time, you go first this time.
I'll try B.
All right. Little Tommy's mother screamed, Tommy! Tommy, how many times do I have to tell you, don't wash the cat in the blank?
You didn't see that, my classy.
What? No, it doesn't come out.
What happens to me?
Why did you cry?
Here we go. Little Tommy's mother screamed, Tommy, how many times do I have to tell you, don't wash the cat in the blink?
In the dishwasher.
Dishwasher.
It's a
Yeah. All right, Joe, what do you say?
I said in the John.
In the John. That's a good one. What do you got?
I said don't wash the cat in the dryer.
In the dryer. She said the dishwasher. Oh. What do you say?
Well, if you don't get it.
In the bidet.
In the bidet. Uh-huh. All right. Ava, how many times do I have to tell you don't wash the cat in the...
pool, if you got one.
In the pool. All right.
I don't blame you.
I liked it.
I thought it was blame a good answer.
Yes, sir.
What if you ride?
This kind of thing just never happens to me. These two ladies are...
Yeah. They're coming on strong.
Yeah, so
look,
I said, don't
you
wash
wrote,
your cat in the toilet.
All right. What did you write?
I wrote, don't wash your cat in the dishwasher.
Yeah. One for Mary, one another to score. God, now this for you.
What? I lost part of my cufflink here, and maybe we'll find it. I hope we find it before next show, or I'm going to have to come out here naked. You join us. See you. Tune in and see if Gene finds his cufflink. Bye.
Where?
Today's contestants will also receive a Fabergé collection featuring organic shampoo and conditioner, both with pure wheat German honey for fresh smelling hair with Super Shine Super Body Organic Splash Fabergé. A fry pan and Hollywood safflower oil, higher in polyunsaturated and other oils. Hollywood safflower oil contains no cholesterol from Hollywood foods. A tray and Search, the breath mint that gives you the confidence of knowing your breath is clean. Search, available in snappy cinnamon flavor. And a calculator in Future makes old-looking no-wax floors look young again. That's why Future's recommended for no-wax floors. The stars from Dallas, Steve Kennelly, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Jamie Lee Curtis, Richard Paul, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn!
John.
Woo!
Does it make me a bad person?
Takes a man to wear red shoes, I tell you that.
Are you ready? That's right.
Yes.
I'm at your rose. That's not all, honey. Shall we have a go at it?
Why not, John?
Okay, greet Laura Sands and Randy Sherwood. Welcome. We'll get acquainted first by finding out a little bit about each of you. Randy, let's begin with you.
Well, after getting out of the Navy, I majored in broadcast management in college, was a disc jockey a number of times, and worked in an engineering capacity in television down in San Diego. And I'm unemployed now.
It's a difficult business to get into, isn't it?
Very competitive. Very competitive.
Tough.
You got to really know people and be places.
That's right.
That's right.
Well, good luck
Thank
here,
you.
And good luck in your continued career. Laura, let's hear about you.
Well, I was born and raised in Denver, Colorado, and I moved out here about a year ago, and now I am a clerical typist.
All right.
Short and sweet.
Laura, good luck to you, too. Here on Match Game PM, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of our stars as you can. The one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, where you can win over $20,000. Begin. Randy, A or B?
I'll take B, please.
He says he wants B. When the Martians landed, they decided there was no intelligent life on Earth because they landed in blank.
Got it.
By the end of the program, you have to tell me the connection between the Titanic and Denver, Colorado.
Uh-huh. The connection between the Titanic and Denver, Colorado. Do you happen to know?
See that? That's why a show like this should be informative and filled with wonderfully interesting things.
Well,
there
I'll
is
think
a connection,
it.
Right?
There is a connection.
Right.
We'll
you
find
don't
out.
Know it, do you? You got your red accessories up the gazoo. But
okay, Randy. When the Martians landed, they decided there was no intelligent life on Earth because they landed in blank.
Washington, D.C.
Okay, Randy. Steve, I think he's on to us.
What did he say?
He said Washington, D.C.
That's what I said, too.
Yeah. Ms. Brett.
What are we going to do for the rest of the evening if we all say Washington, D.C.?
I don't know. We'll pray for a tie.
I want to thank Miss Roberta Peters of the Metropolitan Opera for lending her fourth act Lucia costume to Brett so she could do the show.
Yeah,
Washington.
Washington.
Zero.
But he's trying. Hello, Jamie.
Hi.
When the Martians landed, they decided no intelligent life on Earth because they landed in...
beautiful downtown Burbank.
Yeah.
Burbank.
Sorry, I did.
And you, sir?
Well, when they landed, they said, take me to your leader. And they came to see me. But, I must say I was so afraid because for a minute those little green men looked quite a bit like a very nasty rabbit. And I was frightened.
And you didn't have no peanuts on you?
Nothing.
All right. Miss Fanny.
Well, I said that they landed in a match game run through. But then I don't care to work again. I mean, what difference does it make?
I'll hit you with my red shoe. Okay, four for Randy. Look at him. Now, Laura, you'll have three opportunities to catch up. Let's see what it says here. Billy said, when I was born, my parents kept me in a jar. For years, I thought I was a blank. Okay, Laura. Billy said, when I was born, my parents kept me in a jar. For years, I thought I was a blank.
Pickle.
Pickle jar.
Well, I think I came close, but you probably won't allow it. A pickled pig's foot.
Yeah. Pickled pig's foot. No.
There's the word.
No, wait a minute. Pickled
pig's foot.
Pickles and pig's feet are two different items.
Yeah.
See, but...
So are cucumbers and pickles.
Right. No, they're not.
I almost got you, didn't I, you little devil? I think we're going to have another no-show. Dill Pickle.
Dill Pickle. Okay. Where are we? 41?
I went right down to the heart. Just a simple word and a match. Pickle.
All right, you got it. Here it is. When I was born, my parents kept me in a jar. For years, I thought I was a...
Pickle.
Why are you so sad?
I felt like being sad.
You wanted to display a sad emotion?
Yes, so that they wouldn't think I had.
So. Oh, I see. I got you. Richard Paul.
Specimen. V.
physical specimen.
Oh, that's good. You can't crawl out of that one. Miss Fanny, rescue us from this, will you?
Daddy Paul, so amusing. I said pickle.
So in round one, we have a tie score. Round two coming up in a moment or so. Right now, this for you. Now, see, we have a tie score here. We'll go to round two in a moment or so. But I just want to clarify the thing about Denver. Do you understand what it is?
I sure do.
Do you understand what it is?
What?
I mean, do you want to explain it, Charles?
Oh, Molly Brown, right? The unsinkable Molly Brown was called that because she was on the Titanic and she didn't sink. And when I go to Denver, I always say at the Brown Palace, which is very nice. That's why the musical was called The Unsinkable Molly Brown. And it's not that important, but it's interesting. These things are very interesting.
Are you trying to tell us that she came from Denver?
It's all so heavy. Heavy and interesting.
He's not heavy. He's your brother.
Oh. I feel so refreshed.
You know what they would say to you on the Titanic? Men and women and all guys with a lot of red accessories first.
Men and women and red shoes first.
Save
okay,
the red
Randy went first last time, so Laura, we ask you to go first this time.
B, please.
B?
B.
Okay.
True.
What? No.
You hear voices now, don't you? The Titanic is coming back to get you.
One farmhand said to another, he said, Farmer Brown is really mean. He's the only farmer in the world that uses his wife as a blank. You're the only two. Steve and Richard are the only two who play. Okay.
Great.
Laura, one farmhand said to another,
put it in the slot.
Farmer Brown. One MC per show, if you please. One farmhand said to another, Farmer Brown is really mean. He's the only farmer in the world that uses his wife as a...
plow horse.
Yeah! Plow horse. Exactly. The answer was plow horse from her lips. What'd you say?
To God's ear.
Yeah, it's the 20th century, so close. A tractor.
Tractor. And you, sir?
Well, the woman had a very large, well, sharp, pointed nose, and he just grabbed her by the ankles and used her as a plow.
As a plow. So there's no match there. She said plow horse.
You are a sadist. You are a sadist, Richard Paul.
She had long nails, and she was a pitchfork.
Well.
Now, Randy, let's see if you make any progress here. Old man Periwinkle said,
there you go.
What did he say?
17 is when your sex drive goes into first gear. 65 is when your sex drive goes into blank.
Sixty-five is when your sex drive goes into
reverse.
Reverse. What do you say to that, Jamie?
It actually should go in the repair shop, but actually goes into reverse.
Uh-huh. And what do you say to that?
I hate to think of life as just a set of gears.
Reverse.
Reverse. Now, Laura, we'll go to round three. He's matched all six of our stars. That means you have one chance to match the two you haven't matched, and you can have A or B.
A this time.
All right.
A.
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 Somebody made that.
A, baby.
Yes. Ben said, my sister is really strange looking.
How strange is she?
Very good.
Not quite in unison.
It's
you must
that
be
way.
In unison. What time must you be in unison? Meet me in unison in the rest. She just had a sweet 16 party. That's not her age, it's her blank size.
Oh,
All right. My sister is really strange looking. She just had a sweet 16 party. It's not her age, it's her blank size.
Bra size.
Bra size. Gotta match them both. Steve, what do you say?
Well, I was thinking we're still doing the daytime show. I said shoe size.
Shoe size. So that means Randy wins the game. What do you have? Bra. You missed it by one. Come on down, Randy. Here we go. Randy Sherwood, the winner. It was a pleasure to meet Laura Sands. I'm going to send some gifts to you from Match Game PM. Laura Sands, ladies and gentlemen. Here's a little message for you. Hurry back. Randy Sherwood believes this is a fortuitous moment for him because he is unemployed. And he has a chance to win over $20,000 at this moment. If you had a job, Randy, it would take you 2 or 3 weeks to earn that amount. At least today. Yes. Here we go. We polled a studio audience in this very room. Very smart bunch like these here. And we said, if you please, write down your best answer to this. The eyes of blank. Now, if you give us the answer, which they wrote down most often, we'll give you $500. For matching the second most popular answer, $250 for you. And if you match the third, we give you $100. Now, as you call on three of our six stars, call on the ones who have a glimmer of intelligence in their eyes. If you call on the dummies, you're going to strike out. All right, one at a time, if you please.
Jamie.
Jamie.
The eyes of Laura Mars.
The eyes of Laura Mars. The motion picture. Brett.
I say the eyes of the world.
The eyes of the world.
Are right. Upon you.
Now look over.
Could we get
carefully.
A little stretch there?
Richard.
Texas, son.
The eyes of Texas.
The eyes of Texas are upon you.
The eyes of the world, the eyes of Laura Mars, and the eyes of Texas are the three they've given you. And now you have to make a choice. One of those or one of your own.
Texas is a nifty answer, but my first thought was Laura Mars. Yeah. I'm going with Laura Mars.
You go with Laura Mars. I went with Laura Mars for 2 years.
Was it nice?
No, I didn't like her at all. All right, he wants Laura Mars. We all want Laura Mars. All right, let's find out if we have Laura Mars under the $100 number. The eyes of the world.
Oh,
there's
you
Brett's
all
answer.
When I sat down to play.
Yes, we did laugh. Let's see if we have Laura Mars under the $250 response. The eyes of Texas. Now, I thought that was going to be on top. I really did.
No, if you don't go to the movies, you poor treasure. What are you doing now?
No, I just want to come down and speak for Texas.
Now, wait a minute. You're going to say a word about Texas?
I want to talk about, if Laura Mars comes up here, I'm going to talk about Texas.
Yes. All right. Now, wait a minute.
No, my chick is going to talk about Texas.
No, I've come down to
now,
show
we want
my
to see you that the people choose Laura Mars over a state that is so beautiful as Texas. Go ahead, show your sign.
Okay.
Sam Houston.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
Hold everything.
Wait a minute. I want the senator from Texas over here.
All right.
So they can see the disaster.
Senator, would you come
right
over here?
He's trying to give me a.
Would you get out of the way? Get out so we can get some people up here.
All right.
All right.
Now, I want to say something. All right.
I want the eyes of Texas. All right.
Let's see it.
Ta-da!
Laura
Mars! I feel sorry for you.
Come on, come on. Come on. Come on.
Get off! Get off this stage! It's my show!
Come, Daddy! We'll lynch him late!
At least I got something out of this.
Okay. Stand on the blue dot. Why?
Because he happens to be on Dallas. That's what we've been doing all day.
It's
if
not
he was
my
only
fault.
On the streets of San Francisco, we wouldn't have touched him with a 10 on the
You want to buy those?
I didn't know they made them this big.
Oh, and he thinks he's going to win the money. Okay.
It was the red color.
All right. Where are we?
Oh,
he's won $500, which means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Do you realize that?
Woo!
But we're going to give you another shot at another audience match here. Slide it. Blank dropper.
Oh, boy, I got one.
You got one.
I got one. Call on me. Call on me, Randy.
Oh,
trust me.
Wait a minute.
No,
let's see.
Go
who
back
shall I
to
call?
The eyes of Laura Mars, the eyebrows. Now it's all a plot to get us.
I think I'll call on Brett.
Okay, Brett.
I say, here and now, to y'all, the eyes of Eyedropper.
Eyedropper.
You brought her Eyedropper.
No singing.
Did you see that catch? And they say I'm blind. I am not blind.
Okay, that's one. You want Fanny?
Yeah.
Okay, Fanny.
How would you like her, fried or scrambled?
Over easy.
Over easy.
Oh. Over easy. Over easy.
Precious, precious. Close up your ears. Shut your eyes. Don't.
Come on, Fanny. Give us an answer.
We'll just think he's gonna be rich. Let's see. Snooky Lanson, Snooky Lanson, Snooky Lanson. Name drop.
Name drop.
One more. I go with Jamie again. That was
I go
guys,
with Jamie too.
Guys, you used up all my answers.
You got one?
I got one.
No, I don't have one. I'm sorry. I'm blank.
Honey.
They took my
honey.
Only two.
All right.
Yes, I want to say no. Don't buzz the buzzer. Don't buzz the buzzer. I am going to say Texas dropper. Texas dropper is a bird that flies.
Okay, you got a choice of eyedropper or name dropper. You want one of those or one of your own?
Sure, my first thought was name dropper.
Name dropper is what we want. Let's see if it's under the $100 response.
It's a big one.
Eavesdropper is there. Let's see what we've got under the $250 response. Name dropper it is. Congratulations. Another $250 for you. So that means you've got a total of $7,500.
Wait a minute. See what's under the bottom one.
That you're playing for.
He did the bottom one.
The top one says eyedropper.
Eyedropper.
Okay. $7,500 is what you're playing for. However, you can play for $15,000 if you get a lucky spin of the star wheel. Get up there and spin
Come
it.
Come on and double it up, babe.
Double. And we'll all root for a double. Here we go. Ready, Steve?
Go, Steve.
Okay. Good luck to you. Stand on the little blue dot there facing me, if you would, please. Thank you. Here we go. Begin blank. Begin blank. Okay. Now, if you give us the answer that Steve has written on the card, we give you $15,000. What's wrong?
Nothing.
Got to put it in a slot?
Oh, $7,500. Yeah, I didn't hit the double thing there. Okay. Give us an answer, if you would, please.
That was tough. Begin firing.
Oh.
I thought you had the money in your hip pocket.
Young.
All right, turn around here, and we'll ask Steve what answer he has on his card.
Oh, a little Cole Porter tune.
Begin the beginning.
Oh,
wait a minute. What's that?
Before my time.
You have no idea what he's saying, begin the beginning?
Oh, when you begin the beginning.
I still don't.
He still doesn't recognize it. Okay, well, Randy Sherwood has a total of $750 and our best wishes, and now we've got this message for you. Join us next week for Match Game PM. We'll have another bevy of beautiful stars like these. It's a lot more money to give away. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Some contestants.
cuts greasy dirt without streaking and makes shiny surfaces sparkle like glass. Windex shines more than just windows. And a portable radio and Popeyes, fun and delicious, a terrific freeze at home treat. 12 hours in assorted flavors, treat your youngsters with refreshing Popeyes. And the Polishell system from Turtle Wax, space age protection for your car's finish, 3 layers deep, 24 months long, the Polishell system.
Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.